There's another connection that she may not know, but although I've said it in many, many interviews, when I was 17 and I went to the School of Engineering and Architecture in Canada, I was really obsessed with Laszlo Mahalunas, obsessed with it. So there's, I think, another connection. I mean, it's great to be at the school.
I wanna change the world.
I think ideally, it's almost like design should be taught strictly in a graduate level, not necessarily in an undergraduate level. This is what I observed. And I guess I observed this because the frustrating part about a lot of the years I spent in academia and students was that they didn't know enough about the world, and they were immediately specializing in designing something. But it's almost like if they were a little bit more intellectual, more experienced, and more maybe educated in a rounder, in a more holistic way, then they concentrate on design. It's almost like design, and even you could argue architecture, should almost be just a master's driven or a postgraduate study. It's hard to get a good read on the whole kind of academic pedagogy to just by a few students, obviously, but yeah, rigorous. And there was something I think I saw, I noticed in all of them, they had a really good hand, meaning that they really know how to draw. And I think somehow still in the root or the essence of design is that you really have to draw and know how to draw. I mean, you can draw digitally, you don't have to use a pen, but you need to still be able to see the world somehow with a connection of eye and hand and to kind of express your ideas. You know, I taught in 6 schools and I taught in 3 that were quite famous schools. And I was surprised at the time that I never thought the education was diligent or intellectual enough. The design has had a tendency that it's more about making than it is about thinking. When I started teaching, I was teaching at Rhode Island School of Design as an assistant professor in 1990 and 1991. And I remember arriving to the school and there were boxes and boxes of SGIs, computers, sitting in a basement that were donated, about $1 million worth of product donated, sitting there for 6 months because the faculty at that time were afraid to open it up and use it with their students because they didn't know anything about it. It was almost like, and I got there, I remember the president of the school inviting me for dinner and I found out his ulterior motive was to get me to go down there, open those boxes and get the department a bit more up to speed, let's say, with software and with digital, let's say, methodologies. And so things have changed now a lot, and in the sense that I think it's part and parcel of a designer, be it fashion, graphics, digital, media, architecture, that the digital tools are a necessity and they should be seamless with you. That's part of your process of working. You know, even conceptually, the point where, I mean, you can use software not just as a tool, but you can use it as a way to inspire kind of new programs and new ideas and things. So things are, but I think, frankly, the digital and the physical that way should be much more integrated and almost inseparable. And right now we'll use a lot of these tools and a lot of digital media and digital things to kind of build, let's say, the physical world. Or we're using it to build the digital age. But either way, I think that it's has to be part of all the programs. With that said, even if you're really efficient with all these tools, it doesn't mean necessarily you're getting an education. So the next part of the education is really going back to what I said earlier about kind of understanding theory.
Let's make love more. Let's make love more.
I was thinking, I would really like a pink one. No, I'm serious.